BBC introducing
in Hereford and Worcester.
So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to West Malvern Social Club. Now, this group are a five-piece rock band who are influenced by Oasis, Arctic Monkeys, and many others. They won a competition a couple of years back now and managed to record at the legendary Rockfield Studios, which of course is where Queen recorded Bohemian Rhapsody. They also went on the following year also to record at another studio as a result of winning another local competition as well. They're from Hereford. They are Faultline!
purpose alone will satisfy. Music to the social suicide. Give a heads up, will not be blamed. Music says who I'm gonna play. Leave us alone, we're satisfied. Music to the social suicide. Give a heads up, will not be blamed. Oh yeah.
Thank you.
We've got the next song for you, which was written only a few weeks ago. It's called Third World War.
About we have no doubts. Oh no. It busts a large drop through the plum anyway to walk. Close a life like a dog. I'll knock top into a Hollywood heart. Picking up the pieces of the third world war. Can you hear me shouting your records into the world? You've got yourself to blame. I'll knock top into a Hollywood heart. Picking up the pieces of the third world war. Can you hear me shouting your records name to the world? You've got yourself to blame. What's the matter? A war is no crime. That guy won't mess about. We have no doubt. Oh no. It busts a large drop to the floor. Maybe wage a war. Close a life like a dog. I'll knock top into a Hollywood brawl. Picking up the pieces of the third world war. Can you hear me shouting? Pieces of the third world war. Can you hear me shouting your records name to the world? You've got yourself to blame.
Unsigned,
Undiscovered. And under the radar music.
Here we are then, it's Mothering Sunday. We're outside the West Malvern Social Club. The sun's shining, the birds are tweeting. Everyone seems to be very happy. You all happy, guys?
Yeah.
Good, okay. This is Fault Line. Although Hereford seems to be a million miles away from any kind of fault line, what kind of inspired you to name the band after it?
I was sitting in the science class and, you know, not really doing the work as such, but thinking, what could we name our band? We're doing all about earthquakes and fault lines, and I thought, well, we have a reputation at our gigs for blowing the roof off the place, usually.
I like it.
So
there we go.
By calling it Fault Line, you know, I was doing about it, it just came to me, and I said, why not Fault Line? And then, of recent, we've added Lauren to the band, and Lauren has come up with an even more detailed meaning, which is that we were the line, but she's the fault in the line, because she's the girl in the band. That's,
okay.
That's her idea.
A good fault, a good fault.
I don't know.
So this was at school. Is that where you met the rest of these guys?
Yeah.
Bishops of Hereford Bluecoat.
Yeah. What have you taken in your options?
I've taken music.
Good.
You've taken music too, haven't you, Si?
Yeah, and Jolly.
No, I dropped it.
You dropped it?
Yeah.
What have you chosen in place?
Art.
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 So I want to design your CD covers.
I've got an artistic singer.
CDs are dead.
Yeah.
And downloads now. What are you doing?
Not music. Geography, I guess.
I suppose you needed to study that because you kind of got lost because you're originally from Devon. You ended up in Hereford somehow.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
Hey, I'm not such a good geographer, I guess.
Yeah. Came on holiday to Hereford and we kind of stole you a bit, didn't we?
Yeah.
All right. Is that what it was? It was like a holiday romance with the band Fault Line.
No, just sort of moved here about 4 years ago now and just kind of liked it since, really.
Yeah, because originally we had a different drummer, but you went to Monmouth
and
Leinster.
Wilderness of Leinster, yes.
Yeah. And you've done really well at like competitions that you've been entering, the first of which was your Rockfield experience. That must have been pretty epic.
Well, this was going 2 or 3 years ago now, so this is a while back. Yeah, we were shocked when we won it and we were like, wow, okay. And Rockfield Studios is all a bit surreal, really, and just went from there, recorded White Lies and...
That was before your time with the band, was it?
Before
yeah,
time.
I've been
so
in
you
for
missed
like...
all the enjoyable bits.
Yeah, I've been in for like a month and a half.
What was Rockfield like? Just describe the kind of surroundings.
It was amazing. We'd never gone to a recording studio or anything.
We learned a lot.
So it was, yeah, miking up everything was just crazy.
Did they show off their fancy walls?
They showed off their very fancy walls, yes.
Yeah. We should explain for people listening at home, they've got these walls that when you press a button, the shape of the wall changes. They're all like slats. They're like vertical blinds, but kind of down there. And it kind of turns it from like this box kind of cupboard into this echoey room like a cathedral.
It's really cool. The sound and the acoustics in there are just awesome.
And then you weren't just content with winning one competition, you went and won another.
Well, we won a couple more actually. We went to a studio over in Leinster and that was good fun in there.
I said earlier on that reading from your profile, I might add, that you were originally influenced by Oasis, Stereophonics and Arctic Monkeys. What happened with these Stereophonics? Why did you fall out of love with them?
Who typed that on there?
I didn't really ask your opinion, I guess.
Mostly, I take a lot of our influences from Foo Fighters and Queens of the Stone Age as well.
Okay.
Yeah. This can be reflected in our music.
So the more edgy side of rock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not handbags and glad rags.
Yeah. We're all for the side of rock that, you know, where it's got a bit of attitude and a bit of emotion to it.
Not that Devon rock.
No. Herefordian rock.
Yeah. And how did you become the new addition to the band then? Were they just not happy being a four-piece?
I had a message from Tyler on Facebook saying, do you want to sing for us at Bishop's Got Talent? I was like, oh, okay then.
Had you sang before?
Not in front of people, no.
Oh, okay.
She came onto the big stage with a bang, it was pretty stunning stuff.
Do you all get nervous?
I don't move when I'm on stage, so I just sort of stand there.
Is that nerves?
Yeah.
You'll get used to it.
It'll come with experience,
Yeah. Just keep gigging. Are you doing many gigs then?
The jailhouse.
Yeah, we played there.
It must have been a pretty neat gig.
We do that every other month, I think.
We do a lot of gigs at school as well. The school love us. So.
Good. And what's your plans once school is over then?
Well, once we finish our GCSEs, we hope to just really get some proper big gigs lined up and perhaps get into a recording studio or something and get an album done. You know, we've made a few breakthroughs this year. We woke up one morning on our YouTube channel to find like 70,000 views on one of our videos and we thought, whoa. So we're doing okay.
So that's going to give you, a couple of years or so, isn't it? And then it's decisions about university and moving to places like Devon.
We hope in the next few months after school we could go on tour, perhaps into the wilderness of Devon instead of Leinster. We enjoy everything and that's why we do it. We enjoy it and we love it and that's why. Yeah.
Right, and you'll start to move as the confidence improves.
Yeah.
Well, you've got no fears there. You know, you're a great sounding band, so thank you for coming down and playing for us today.
It's been a great honour.
Yeah, yeah, no problem at all. Thank you.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston.
So for the next one, we've got a very special guest and a new addition to the band, Lauren Haycock, who's going to be singing for us in the next two songs. The first one is called Dream, and it's been written a while back, but this has been heavily modified and it sounds really, really good now. As mentioned before, about 2 years ago, maybe three now, we wrote a song called White Lies, and we recorded it at Rockfield Studios, and I have to say, it's probably my favourite one. Brought to you by me and Lauren, Geordie, Ty and Shay. Hope you enjoy.
Say you know nothing and you will survive. Deny, deny, deny. secrets, and I am feeling the heat. The moon spread like chillers with my street. And you hear the sound of defeat and the speech taking hurt.
And your life to spread, just keep your mouth shut on the watch ahead. This little white lies only sheet in my shed. Say you know nothing and you will survive. Tonight, tonight. Shut all our watch a bit. Still white lies, don't be sheen in my sin. Say you know nothing and you will survive. Tonight, tonight.
Introducing in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston.
West Malvern Social Club. There's a familiar face in the audience. Hello, what's your name? Where are you from?
Hi, I'm Dan Johnson. I'm from Malvern. This is my favourite place to come and watch music. I come here a lot. Great barman behind you there, and great way to spend a Sunday afternoon.
We've just seen Faultline from Hereford. What do you think of them?
Yeah, they're interesting. They're young, they're raw, they've definitely got something, and look out for them.
Hi, what's your name? Where are you from? Just about to put the pork scratching in his mouth.
Yeah.
Shall I come back in a second?
Yeah.
I'll do that. Hi, what's your name? Where are you from?
Morris from Hereford. That was really good. Something new, something I've never heard of, and something really good.
I'm Emma and I'm from Worcester. Well, my nephew is the lead singer in there, so we came to support him today.
Okay, how would you describe their music?
Different. Not my cup of tea, but very good, considering they're a group of 15, 16-year-olds.
Surprising enough, once they described a band as not my cup of tea myself, and they use it as a quote on their website.
Hey, probably pinched it from me.
That's probably it.
I'm Emily, and I'm from Hereford. They're really good. It's really unique. It's like rock, but with a twist.
I'm Eric. I'm from Malvern.
Regularly here at West Malvern Social Club?
Yeah, I'm on the committee, so, you know.
Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't know that. We used to jam together about 30 years ago, didn't we?
Yes, 30 years ago, yes. But I've been playing music for a long time now. They're very good, this band. I like them. It sounds very retro, though, like an 80s sound, isn't it? You know, Sham 69 sort of feel, or something a bit punky.
Funny, I saw Sham 69 a couple of weeks ago. Mind you, one of the many versions of them.
They're still going.
In some one form or another. What sort of music do you usually listen to, Eric?
I'm in a folk band, but I listen to drum and bass and house mostly. Yeah.
Listen to the best interviews online.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.